tip. Have you ever needed chicken gravy or beef gravy and just didn't have time to make it or didn't have the materials on hand for making it? Here's a quick and easy way you can do that. I've got some butter in my skillet right here, and we'll turn it down now. I had melted the butter, and it was about half this much, 1 1/2 tablespoons of butter. To that, I'm going to add 1/8 of a cup of flour, so it comes up to the 1 ounce mark there. So I'm just going to whisk that in very quickly. And try to keep it from lumping. If you can, just whisk very fast. And then pour in, if it's chicken, you pour in your chicken broth. And whisk, and just continue to do that until it will be the consistency that you want. So I'll need more. And I have another can there if I should need to open another can, but I don't expect to. If you need beef gravy, then use beef broth. But the trick here is to keep whisking all the time. So just keep adding what you feel like you need to get it to the liquidity that you want. Turn it up a little bit, let it bubble some, and whisk. And you'll have a nice cream gravy. And I will say this, if you have baked a chicken or something like that, maybe turkey or roast beef, and you have the drippings from that, then use the stock from that instead of using the canned stock. But if you are just out of everything and you want gravy, usually you'll have something like beef stock or chicken broth in your pantry, and you can very quickly put it together into a gravy like this. Doesn't that look good? I'll probably serve that with our chicken dinner tonight. Hope you enjoy it. Here's my quick tip, chicken gravy, and you'll see that it's nice and smooth, and you'll see that there is some brown on the top. What I did was go ahead and fry the chicken, and then I kept the gravy warm, or I didn't keep it warm, but I warmed it back up, ready to serve with the chicken. And after I had taken all the chicken out of the pan, then I drained off the grease, and there was all this good stuff at the bottom. So you can stir that in if you want, or just leave it sitting there in the middle, but that will add a lot of flavor to your gravy. If you have stock and you don't want to have to make your gravy at the last minute, then just make it ahead and then use your beef stock or your chicken stock and stir it in right at the last minute, and it will be delicious.